the interesting reading this morning out of Romans. What then are we to say? Should we continue in sin in order that grace may abound? Right? I was listening to some podcasts this past week about these passages this morning, and one of the professors from Luther Seminary talked about how her sister had a friend when he was younger. He said, you know, I really like to sin, and God likes to forgive sin, so therefore we make a really good team. Right? That's what that passage says, right? You know, that because we're going to get grace, we can do whatever we want. No, thank you. That's not what that means, right? It's not a free license to do whatever you want, right? Some people will take out of context a quote that Martin Luther sent in a letter to Philip Melanchthon. The quote is, you know, sin boldly. That you should do things boldly and that are wrong. And that's not what he meant. You have to read the entire quote. When Luther said this to Melanchthon, he was saying, live your life and live it in such a way that you're not worried about whether or not you're going to do right or you're going to do wrong, because we're covered by God's grace. And we're covered by that regardless of what we do. That doesn't mean that we go out and seek to do wrong, but we go out and seek to live our lives in such a way that our lives are covered with God's grace. And we're showing that grace to everyone out there. It's like this last line of that reading, too. I'm going to bookmark us here. You know, that was the first verse. We'll come back to the second verse in a second. But this past week, I was at a Bible study with one of our members here, and they were wondering about that last verse, right? It says, so you also must consider yourselves dead to sin and alive to God in Christ Jesus. But are we ever truly dead to sin? Is there ever a day you can go without committing a sin? Well, there is, but it's after you're no longer here. Right? As we're alive here on this earth, there's no day that we can go without committing a sin. It's not possible. But the thing that we shouldn't focus on is the fact that we are sinners. The thing that we should focus on, and this Roman reading tries to get us to focus on, is the fact that we are saints. The fact that in that water, God names us and claims us, just as we're going to see here in a little bit. And don't think I didn't orchestrate this. Talking about baptism, and there happens to be a baptism. I planned it 10 months ago. No. But this morning we're going to see God name and claim Colton as his own child through those waters. And it's that life that we're supposed to live into. Martin Luther also said, not only did he say, be a mighty sinner and sin boldly, but he also said, every time you wash your face every morning, remember your baptism. See, this is not a once and done thing. It's an everyday existence. It's something that we live into every day. Because Paul starts his letter to the Romans out here in chapter 6, and he says, because we have grace, should we continue to sin in order that grace may abound even more? And what is his answer? By no means. Or, are you kidding me? What are you thinking? That's ridiculous. That's not how we're supposed to live, right? Our lives are governed by sin. But because we've been named and claimed by God in those waters, we can no longer live to that life. We have to live our life devoted to God. And we can live our lives devoted to God because of what he did for us.
But here I have a question for you. Right? Like I said, in a few minutes, Colton's going to go over there, and he's going to get baptized. But all that is water. It's a little bit warmer than this water is right here. But this water, what does this do for you? They used to sell, this one doesn't have the label, I was hoping it did. They used to sell water bottles, and they have everything now has nutritional labels on them, right? So if we were to read a nutritional label off a bottle of water, it would actually look something like this.
This is actually a nutrition label off a bottle of water, right? Those of you in the back probably can't read it, but that's, you know. It says amount per serving, 0 calories. So there's no calories. There's no saturated fat. There's no fat. There's no saturated fat. There's no trans fat. There's no cholesterol. There's no sodium. There's no carbohydrates. There's no sugars. There's no nothing. There's no vitamin A, no calcium, no vitamin C, no iron. Everything is zero. It has no nutritional value whatsoever. But if you went longer than 2 days without having any of this, well, you could go longer than 2 days, but your body would start to feel the effects of not having water after 2 days. And if you didn't drink any water for a very long time, you would actually die. It gives us absolutely nothing, but it's essential for life. But on the flip side of that, what does it give us over there? The nutritional facts of baptism. No, I did not come up with this. I stole this from another pastor. Right? Those waters over there, when it's infused with God's word, because normal water can't do all of this stuff. But when you put God's word with us and the promise that God said that he was going to name and claim whoever it is that's washed in those waters, we get forgiven of everything that we've ever done. We get God's grace. We get the gift of the Holy Spirit. We get sealed by the cross of Christ. We get God's mercy. And we get included into God's family. How much? We get 100% of it. Every last one of them. You're forgiven 100%. You're included 100%. There's no part of you that's not included. In those waters of baptism, God gives us 100% of everything that we could ever need to live a life in him. And that's the other part of that Romans lesson that it talks about, right? Where are we baptized? Read down in there a little bit. That Romans lesson says, we are, for everyone who is, it's verse 2 actually, verse 3. Do you not know that all of us have been baptized, what's the word there?
Into Christ Jesus. We're accepted and claimed as God's own children, baptized into the life of Jesus Christ. This gift of water is something that washes over us and forgives us of all of our sins and names us and claims us, but it's not a one-time deal, right? Because you have to repent and come for baptism, and God washes you. But every morning you remember that baptism. Not that that it didn't take. When you wash your face, you remember the fact that God named you and claimed you here. That he said that you were his child. Every time you wash your face, you remember that. And you remember that you became a part of Jesus Christ. You became a part of the body of God, walking and moving in this place to share forth his grace, his mercy, and love. Right? Because the Acts reading tells us that who needs to do this? When they heard all of this stuff, Peter, this is the Pentecost reading, right? Where the tongues of fire set upon the apostles, and they start speaking out about the gospel, and everybody hears them in their own language, and they're all just wondering what the world's going on, and Peter explains to them all of this stuff that's supposed to happen, and how Jesus came and died for all of our sins, and when they hear this, they're cut to the heart, and Peter said to they said to Peter and the other apostles, what should we do? And Peter said, repent and be baptized. And all of your sins will be forgiven, and you will receive the gift of the Holy Spirit. When you come to these waters, God gets rid of everything. And he gives you everything that you could ever possibly need. Once and for all is done. Remember it every day as you wash your face. Because that's how much God loves you. Right? And when we talk about baptism, I said Colton is going to be baptized here in a little bit. It's not actually Colton that's doing anything up here. It's not me either. I'm going to say some words, and I'm going to pour water over his head and probably make him cry. He's smiling at me right now, but in here in a few minutes, he's probably going to be yelling at me. Right? It's not me or him that does anything. It's not the parents. It's not the godparents that do anything up here. They make promises to him, which they have to fulfill later on in life, to help raise him and teach him about God. But it's all God that does everything right there at that font. It's all God that does everything in our lives to name us and claim us as his children. It's all God who loved you more than you could love yourself and said that you are my beloved child. And you are well pleased. And you are a part of my kingdom. You are a part of my family. Just walk your life in me. Follow after where I lead. And I will always be with you. That's how much God loves us. That's how much God loves us. Enough to say that you're mine. And to forgive you of everything that you've ever done. And to give you the tools to live a life to show his love, grace, and mercy.
So remember that every morning when you wash your face. That this bottle of water can't really give you anything.
But if you don't drink it, you're going to die. Where that water will give you everything you ever need. And you don't ever have to drink it. And you don't have to do anything to give it. Because God wants to give it to you freely. So remember that you are God's child. Chosen and beloved. Called to be his beacons of hope. In a world that so desperately needs to see his love.